here's the interesting thing about this. Once you take the bolts off of this retaining plate, then literally pulls right off. And when you do this, if you haven't drained your transfer, then you lose a bunch of oil. I'm gonna gently pull this axle out of here. Hopefully I didn't damage anything. That's one way to get it off. I knew that nasty old spare would come in handy somehow. This guy was really rusted in. So yesterday I took this upper control arm and ran it through this wire brush and took a lot of rust off. I'm gonna show you the one I'm gonna be working on today. So this is what this control arm looks like. So I'm gonna take this and work it out on this guy and see if I can clean him up as much as the other one.
Sunset, it's a Friday night. You smoke a cigarette and put on a leather jacket. You're the king of the world, but you could get any girl. Well, baby, maybe you can.
Another afternoon, late afternoon, sun is about to go down. I'm gonna grab a few minutes at the end of the day and see if I can cut off this collar and the bearing from the axle. Make sure you're wearing your goggles, glasses, and I have earplugs in as well. You don't wanna hit the axle if you can help it. This is so tight, your tolerances here are so tight
that it just made sense to go ahead and try to cut off all the bearing part that is blocking what you're trying to get at here, because this is so close. I don't want to score the axle at all. And so I scored both sides of the outer retainer. The chase, I don't know what it's called. I'm not a bearing aficionado or a mechanic, so I'm just gonna let you guys tell me what you call that. I'm gonna cut this bearing retainer off here, get these bearings out of the way, and then cut the rest off. I'll probably only get to do this one before the sun's gone, and then I'll do the other one tomorrow. So I got both the retaining collar off and the inner bearing chase off. Off of there. This one's driver's side, so I'm gonna mark it with a D on there for drivers, just so I can keep them the same, just because. I've not seen any guidance that says to do that, but I'm gonna do it anyway. Right now I'm gonna clean the rust off of these guys. Ow. Boy, that was right in the forehead. Okay, so be really careful when you're doing this. Looks good. Huge difference between that and that. Very nice. So, another day. It's a Sunday. It's gorgeous. Not a cloud in the sky. The birds are singing like crazy people. Amazing. So I went down to a neighbor's house who's kind enough to help me out with finalizing these bearings, getting them pressed on and in place. And it is just an amazing thing to actually see them all back together. I'm very thrilled. So I'm going to clean up the splines a little bit with a brass brush. All right, so I'm going to yank these 14 mils off. So what I'm going to do is take a little bit of Scotch-Brite. There's some rust in there. I need to clean that out before I try to get the bearing back in place. Before you reassemble this, you want to take and put some multi-purpose grease inside on the oil seal. So you get that done. You want to clean off all of your mating surfaces. I'm using isopropyl. It calls for a standard Toyota gasket sealer. I am using on this Permatex Right Stuff 90 minute gasket maker. Okay, then I'm gonna press him into place. You need to make sure that you line up that bottom notch with the bottom notch here. Make sure it makes contact all the way around while the silicone, if you're using Right Stuff, you have to do it while it's still damp. You have to do the gasket material on both sides of the retainer gasket and the end gasket. So we're going to do this. Like so. Then you have the paper gasket. If you want to know what this part number is, it is axle bearing plate retainer gasket 42425-30031. Once again, line it up. The bottom faces down. When you slide this into the axle housing, you have to do it very carefully. That's it. It is in. Press that in place. You're just going to put them into where they're hand tight while this gasket material all seals up. Okay. So let's move to the other side. Your outer hub here has these holes in them so that you can line up to those bolts back behind. So the torque specs for these bolts is 53 pounds. It's been over an hour, so I'm gonna go ahead and torque them down. So roll it around till you line it up and then just tighten it up. Cool. I've said it before and I'll say it again. When you're done with your torque wrench, always set it back down to the storage weight, which for this is 10 foot-pounds. Now we get to build our brake drums. Okay, I'm matching these up. So that looks like that. And then that looks like that. This is my new cylinder. It goes inside the drum. I'm going to use some brand new bolts to install this. So the way that I'm determining this is I'm looking at these brake drums, and you see up here on the front side, there's a wide portion here on the top of the drum. If you look on this side, it doesn't have that. The actual drum material goes right to the edge of the metal. So I'm doing the same thing here with my new one. Open metal up here, less brake drum material. This is tighter on this side. These are the actual plungers for the piston. Those are the points that press inside these pistons. So I'm going to start disassembling this so I can put it up here and figure out how all this stuff goes together. So as you'll notice, this goes into that little groove there, but into the hole on that side. Okay, there's that. Gotcha. I love my vice grips sometimes. Ah, there's the other one. Okay, good. That it gets the larger horseshoe. Okay, good. You have to install this spreader before you install this. All right, so on these contact points here is where the brake shoes are gonna basically come to rest. So I'm gonna use this Anti-Seize VersaChem Type 13 high temperature copper formula. You basically just want to put enough on there for the side of the steel to rest against. And it's gonna go just like that. You feed through the back. That goes like that. Spring goes over top, and you're gonna have to press it in. I don't wanna crush it, I just wanna grip it. Okay, and it has to be oriented right so the spring sits in there like it's supposed to. Okay, cool. There we go, got it. So that holds that in place. And you're gonna have to do all of this by feel. Go. Okay, so it's in. Good. And then you have to do this guy. Just cannot get. All right, folks, so it's the end of another day, and I have successfully been able to put this together. Really, this was a challenge. This was a real challenge, especially not mounted on the vehicle. I had to have help holding it still while I stretched the spring out. Everything's in good shape, and I'm gonna go ahead and move to the other side. We've got a massive storm rolling in from the west, so I'm gonna say bye for tonight. And I will see you as I get another good day and get the axle under the car. Have a good one. See you next time. As always, if you enjoy it, subscribe, like, share your knowledge.